Welcome to the B-side.
Yeah.
Y'all ready for some music? Yeah. Welcome to An Evening With. This is our fourth episode. And my wife and I are from the Peterson compound. We put on the show for singer-songwriters to sing their songs and share the stories that go with them. So the most important part beyond their music is your ears. So thank you for coming out tonight. This fourth episode, we're welcoming from Nashville, Noah G. Fowler. Amazing local talent, Michael Graber. Also local, amazing talent, Tyler Beretta. So I get to see he has a few fans out here tonight, huh? So we're going to get right to the music. At some point in the evening, if you have a question, we do a Q&A. And we encourage you to either ask me to ask him a question or take the mic and ask yourself so you can get to know them better. Thanks for coming out, y'all.
Yeah. Well, my name is Noah G. Fowler. I came here from Nashville. And the first song I'm going to play doesn't have much to do with Nashville. It's a lot more to do with where I grew up, which is in a small town in south central Pennsylvania in what's called the Cumberland Valley. When I was young, my folks would take me to the Gettysburg battlefields a lot, and it was also a very common school field trip. And to get there, we take a road called Route 15, and there's a stretch of about a mile on Route 15 where all of the businesses and restaurants and gas stations and everything are all in Spanish, which I never understood as a kid, but as I got older, I found out that was because there was a population of migrating workers from Mexico that would come through to work all of the orchards in Adams County during harvest season. And some of them would move on and keep traveling, but a lot of them, because of the school systems and the low cost of living, would leave their families there while they continued to work. And so I ended up growing up with a lot of children of migrant workers in the public schools. But I thought it was kind of unfair that for a long time that the people that were putting the food on our tables weren't really getting any kind of visibility outside of that one kind of stretch of a mile on Route 15. So I wrote this song to kind of do my best to if not tell the story in full justice, at least bring a little bit of attention to it and say a little bit of a thank you to the folks that put the food on our tables.
Hitchhiked here from a far off land, oh, picking fruit, my calloused hands. They call me one apple seed. In Adams County tonight I'll sleep. My compadre's got a pickup truck. Got my own two hands and an ounce of love. Last week was West Virginia, where there's still snow. When we're done, we're going to Ohio. And it's been 10 long years since I left my home. Beautiful mother. Harvest alley seeds in the ground. One day till they'll lay me down. One day till they'll lay me down. to flower, flower to fruit. Oh, feet to goodwill, working boots. Highway to back road, town to town. Oh, fruit to seed back in the ground. And it's been 10 long years since I left. Drop off the kids at public school. They go to learn American rules. Far below minimum wage. Oh, I'm far too tired for my age. And it's been 10 long years since I left my home. Beautiful mother Mexico, I travel with the harvest of the seeds and the ground. One day soon they'll lead me down. One day soon they'll lead me down.
Thank you.
That was beautiful, Noah. Thank you so much. You know, I've always heard that if you have a problem with agriculture, you have a problem with your culture.
That's right.
Yeah. By the way, Noah drove in from Nashville, and we're working for tips. Tyler and I are going to donate our tips to him. So if you're feeling generous, there's a jar up here, and you get a little gas money and some Taco Bell money so he can trace his beans back to where they came from. My name's Michael. They call me Spaceman. I haven't figured out why. And this song I'm going to do is, it's a true story with a little twist. And so when I was about yay high, I was in fourth grade. We were in some little fishing cabin. It was more like a hovel in Bear Creek, Arkansas. Very rustic. I broke out with a fever. It was about 104. And to make me get over this fever, my parents stuck me in this cement block basement with a dirt floor that had these prehistoric sized crickets running around. For whatever reason, I don't know if you've seen the illustrated version of Yellow Submarine, the Beatles movie with the Blue Meanies, but it has some rabbit-eared TV, was playing Yellow Submarine. It was really my first psychedelic experience without realizing it, right, of many. And then all of a sudden, I broke up, my sweat came out, and then my dad was standing above me and said, come here, I know where the fish are biting. And so he and this guy named Red, who was the plant manager, my dad worked at some luggage company, they found this golden spot in this little nook, but all of a sudden, as soon as we got there, it smelled really, really fresh, like somebody was peeling a bunch of cucumbers or something. And so it took us a while. We heard this weird buzz and hiss until we realized it was a cottonmouth breeding ground and it was mating season and they get really aggressive. So I really hadn't forgotten that. It's kind of weird. One snake fell in the boat and was foaming at the mouth right here at my shin. My dad and Red had been drinking all night, obviously. My dad tried to hit it with a paddle and missed it, but got it on the backswing and flung it out of the boat. But so anyway, this song's about such joyous topics.
Mm-hmm.
That, don't worry, that's not the song. That's just the moody introduction. Now, Daddy, I'm red. Been drinking since dawn, and now sun's waning low. Twilight's crept in like a ghost as we rode through a cypress grove. It's dank, it's musty, and my eyes, they start to burn. The scent of the air, sweetest sin. And Red said it looks like the Garden of Eden as a cottonmouth fell on him. As a cottonmouth fell on him. They fell from the trees, swam from the rocks. They tried to get in our canoe. We had entered their breeding ground where they cover the earth like dew. With four in the boat, more rushing from the side, not much we could do. I hit them with my paddle, I prayed to the Lord, I'm not ready to meet my doom. I'm not ready to meet my doom. Oh, there are lots of snakes when the water is this low. Each one has poison in the drink below. Slither underwater, feel it in your soul. There are lots of snakes when the water's this low. Flying everything, just a flash. And I'm not sure if I'm alive until I feel a splash. Then Red fell out screaming, I've been bit. His body's beginning to swell. Then snakes bite into his bloated frame as Daddy and I rode. Oh, there are lots of snakes when the water is slow. Each one has poison in the drink you blow. Slither underwater, feel it in your soul. Lots of snakes when the water is slow. Said lots of snakes when the water is slow. Sorry, I hit a wrong chord during the solo. Anyway, in real life, Red did not get bitten, but it didn't make a good song unless somebody's bloating from snake poison.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I like that, man. As an amateur herpetologist, I love to hear a story where a snake doesn't get harmed, you know, you guys. So I appreciate that. So thank you.
Score one for the snakes.
Yeah. So my name is Tyler. I play in two bands here around town, Everdeen's and Dream Crusher Hope Smasher. In both of those bands, I have very little to no responsibilities of singing. And I only do this a handful of times where I get out by myself in front of people and play, just to make sure I still have the balls to do it. and I've unfortunately got some allergy sinus stuff going on, which is a great excuse for not being able to sing super well. But This is, I actually saw this particular setup put on by Martin last month, and I was, you know, amazed at being able to hear the stories. And now that I'm up here on the other side, it's really cool, very intimate. And I have a much sadder sentiment along with the songs that I'm going to play tonight. I'm going to play three songs tonight written by a dear friend of mine who unfortunately took his own life back in Friday the 13th in December of 2013. So we're coming up on 10 years this upcoming December that I've been without my friend Dallas. And these songs, the beautiful thing about it, the beautiful silver lining of him not being here is that these songs are up to all of our individual interpretations. And I'm going to share with you my interpretations of these songs. And, you know, I hope that you listen to these lyrics and have this music have him in some way, shape, or form go with you out these doors. So this first song is called Marry Me. It's not the Train cover. You know, this is obviously a song about, you know, unrequited love and, you know, not knowing how to process those things. Yeah, and I'm going to try my best to sing it well, but we'll see how it goes. Bitch, but you're cold. 'Cause I was too afraid to say stay away, but I'll let the cards fall. However they may, not saying that it was your fault. Clearly I'm blamed, but you didn't have to say. Just a blind fool being let alone my faith. You deserve better than me. Lately I've been on the bottom of the rocks and I watch you rub it in like you're doing nothing wrong and you leave with him in the middle of my song and my heart descends. And I thought you were my friend. I forgot you're perfect. You never made and never will make a mistake. And I forgot I'm worthless. Just a blindfold being let alone my faith. Thank you. Oh, is that a water? Thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Allie was going to be here, so another artist. I was literally going to ask her to sing the choruses of these songs just so I didn't have to worry about it. But thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, sounded fantastic.
Thank you.
I'm sorry about your loss.
Let's go, man. Let's push on.
Going, yeah. I'm having a good time. Yeah. If I may add, if you would like to get something in return for your dollar, not necessarily gratuity, I did bring my merch with me. I got some shirts and I got some hats and I've also got some stickers and an email list that's completely free to sign up for. All you'll get on the email list is when I'm making new music or passing through town. But anyway, this next one's a song I wrote inspired by a story my grandmother passed down to me. She grew up in Girardville, Pennsylvania, which is deep Irish Catholic coal mining country, and back in the day, it was the anthracite coal capital of the whole country, and there was this massive industry that just revolved around taking Irish and other immigrants off the boats in New York City and putting them on a train and sending them into Pennsylvania to work in the mines. And oftentimes they would work in horrible conditions. They would very often be maimed or killed in their profession, and the companies also oftentimes got out of paying them. So they would say, "Your pay for the week is $5, but you actually owe us $5 because we rented you the pickaxe that you used to mine the coal with." And so they would trap these laborers into debt. And so one day, they all got together and formed a group called the Molly Maguires, which was sort of like a trade union, but also kind of like a mafia, because they would fight back and violent and in basically ways that, you know, were getting a lot of attention and were starting to make a difference. And one day the coal companies decided they had enough of it, so they sent in a priest. Because they thought, oh, these are all a bunch of good Irish Catholics. They would listen to a Holy Father. But this Holy Father's messaging when he was saying, hey, don't, you know, commit crimes, just do your work and keep your head down, was a little too specific. And so the Molly Maguires got together and they roughed him up and told him to get out of town. And the story goes is that he was upset by being roughed up by these Molly Maguires that he put a curse on the town and said the whole town will one day fall into hell, everything will burn to the ground and crumble and fall away. And to show that I'm right, the only thing that will be standing would be the Catholic Church. Now, this all took place in a town called Centralia, which is famous because in the 1960s, the coal mines underneath the town caught on fire and the whole town basically collapsed on itself. And there's only five structures that remain undamaged, and one of them happens to be the Catholic Church in the town. So you can kind of decide for yourselves if you believe in the mysticism of the curse, or perhaps the reason that everything happened the way it did was the reckless and dangerous coal mining conditions that the Molly Maguires were fighting against in the first place. But anyway, this one's called The Ballad of Centralia. I've come here to sing you a story about the fire still burning today under Centralia, heart of Pennsylvania, where now only five people stay. Was in 1869, came a priest from Philadelphia,
to save the town, said their souls were going down. He said, man, I'm here to save you. He said, you better quit all your sinning, for hell has raging fire. Oh, Satan has saved for lazy workers, free thinkers, and Molly Maguires. The Mollies had never been stronger. They fought and died for the working man. They killed our first mayor when he showed too much favor to the companies, putting the town in danger. So they sent us that dirty priest, thinking he could do them a favor, to threaten the souls of the hard-working folks, so they do the unsafest labor. He said, you better quit all your sinning, for hell has raging fire. Oh, Satan has saved lazy workers, free thinkers, and Molly Maguires. So then my great-grandfather, he took three of his best fighting men. Well, they wouldn't kill a deacon, sure as hell ruin his week, and he won't come back to Centralia again. That priest, he did more than frown. Folks say he cursed the whole goddamn town. He said it'll all fall away, and all that'll be saved will be the Church of St. Ignatius. Here comes my part of this story, this one that I'm singing to you. When one day I found in my tanks underground hit a temperature of 172. And it's been 100 years now since they hung all the Molly Maguires. But the town's not done paying for the that Dean was cursed with an underground fire. Everyone had to move out. There's five of us left in town. The fire still burns today, and all that's unscathed is that Church of St. Ignatius. And if heaven is full of executives who made money mining and prophesied, oh, just throw me down in that raging fire in hell with Molly Maguires. And if heaven is full of executives,
thank you.
I'm going to play just this old country simple song that I wrote. I usually don't write like little ditties, and I don't know how or why, but some people like this. I think it's a theme, so I've kind of turned it into a sing-along. It only has four syllables. How many of you sing sometimes in the shower? So if I say something like bump-a-bump-bump, or bump-a-bump-bump, and you go bump-a-bump-bump. That's really good. You're hired. So, the word is marijuana. 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 That's really, hey. So if you like it, sing it with great vigor. I actually got a few gigs canceled because of this song, but my Spotify numbers go up, and it gets played in 40-something countries every 420. You know, it's
yeah.
So it starts back, you know, kind of what they call the ether of prehistory, right? You have to get in your anthropological mindset or something like that. Several thousand years ago, at the end of the ice and the snow, by a stream lived a small nomadic band. They used fibers for their weaving, for fishnets and clothes. A harsh life living off the land. A powerful elixir, it was a magic fixer, an ancient herbal brew. It can take good care of you. You getting ready? So before I say it, I'm about to say the word, right? Pretend you take a bong hit before. So I'll say, marijuana.
Marijuana.
Oh, marijuana.
Marijuana.
Let's all smoke marijuana. After decades of bad press and far too many arrests, we rediscover that it is a cure. The states start changing their laws, and the tax money helps us all. The new strain, so potent and pure. An ancient herbal brew, it'll take good care of you. Increase the joy of living of this life you've been given. A marijuana.
Marijuana.
Good. A marijuana.
Marijuana.
Let's all smoke some marijuana. Medicinal indication. It's safer for you than booze. Won't you take that euphoric cruise on marijuana?
Marijuana.
Oh, marijuana. Marijuana. Now ain't that the way it ought to be? Oh, marijuana.
Marijuana.
Oh, marijuana. Yeah, welcome to the land of the free. So, just because I'm kind of like Santa Claus and have this white beard and a little older, the senior member up here, I've got some advice for you, Noah. So that is, you've got all this good merchandise, but if you really want to make some money on the road, you got to have a secret bottom drawer filled with marijuana. That you, okay.
All right, now to you, Tyler.
Yeah. I like marijuana. I think everybody
should
have
Denver,
one
so.
Or two. That was dope. And Noah, I love your stories too. That was dope. Yeah.
Yeah.
I would say so. But yeah, no, your stories are equally dope, even void of marijuana content. So, again, up to your interpretation, and to give a little bit of backstory, before I do this next song that I'm actually going to try to sing in full force, because I kind of feel like I have one more left in me before I'm like done for. But growing up as a biracial kid in the South, it really honestly wasn't hard for me to find friends. But it's very hard to find good friends, and it's very hard to find people who, when you go through the lowest of your lows, that they're still there with you, and when you go through the highest of your highs. So to kind of do a little bit of a playful, positive note, of course, like I said, he, you know, took his life on a Friday the 13th. This upcoming October, Friday the 13th, I'll be marrying the love of my life over here. Because, you know, there were times after he passed where when I saw Friday the 13th coming up on a calendar, I would cower at it. I would, you know, it was the dark mark of the month, and I would sometimes call out of work. I would shut my phone off. I would be not super in a superstitious way, but just more in a thing where you just didn't want to face it. And one of the things that is the most faceable thing that we're going to have to inevitably deal with in life is loss. And this song, my interpretation of it, is grief. And I'm someone that has unfortunately become way too acquainted with the concept of grief over time, and even recently. And I used to bartend, I still do, but I used to bartend as a full-time job. And I remember I had a guy come up to my job once, and he was sitting at the bar, and he seemed low, and I got to talking to him. And he was an aspiring hip-hop artist here in town, and he was low. And I was like, you know, we're sharing music and stuff, and I was like, hey, I got a recording of a friend of mine. He's no longer here with me, but it's a song called Sweet Dreams. I think you should listen to it. And, you know, he came back up to me a week later, and this is, you know, on my grandmother's health, a true story, and he said that that song saved his life. And this is why I want to play this song, and I want to try to give it the justice of trying to do it the way that he did it. So as I get to the chorus, if things go awry, please, by all means, be nice about it.
You can drown me in a pool of water 20 feet deep, head to toe, pseudo bomber, and I still won't sink. My buoyancy is incredible, your boat is edible, and I'm a shark that ain't eaten in a week. Take the bait, you make me hallucinate like a drug, you make me leave my sober state. But I'd rather have a plaster face. Now I'm lonely and I'm holding on to this empty plate, and I'm still hungry. Fresh suppression to take it like a life lesson. Best approach, I'm guessing, is to slip into a coma, dwell forever in this goddamn depression. But I lost myself in this zoo. Nothing seems to calm the way you do. And every time I wake up, man, I wanna go back to sleep. It's not that I'm still tired, sweeter dreams, but lately when I wake up, I can see you next to me. And as of late, I don't like what I see. Raise my glass to the past, make a toast to the ghost that haunts these halls, suffocates and chokes me into submission, leaves me wishing that I only paid attention, and maybe the trust that I could be clutching, but I I wish I had time to just rewind, gather my thoughts so maybe I could say, every time I wake up, man, I wanna go back to sleep. It's not that I'm still tired, seeking sweeter dreams, but lately when I wake up, I can see you next to me. And as of late, I don't like what I
Thank you.
So that puts us about halfway through. Y'all having a good time? We got a couple different options. Y'all need a break yet? Or you ready to keep on going?
Yeah.
Okay, we could do that. I have a couple of different questions for y'all real quick. And if any of y'all have questions, let me know. Or come up and just grab the mic from me. Do you have anything coming up? I mean, anything you want to share? Anything you want to promote?
Well, I'm recording a record next month in Nashville with Mark Thornton, who's a local producer, and he's kind of the one of the most sought-after guitar players in town. He used to play in Jerry Reed's band, and I'm also I tour and play music full time. It's my livelihood, so I'll be coming back through this way. I'm hoping we can work something out and get a stop here, but I got a tour out west here in August. It's coming up, so if you got any friends out in Denver, Austin, or Dallas, or any of those cities, you let them know I'm coming. Check out the merch table. I made all that stuff. I screen printed it all myself. It's all handmade in my house in Nashville, so that's all the stuff I got to plug. Oh, also, check out the Spotify and the social media and all that stuff. It's just Noah G. Fowler. You'll find me.
Don't forget the G. He's not one of the discount Fowlers
right
out there.
Yeah.
And I understand that you'll sign any body part that, you know, that anybody requests.
That's right.
Yeah, okay. So, how about you, Michael? Anything special coming up?
Yeah, well, I just played the Mississippi Moon Festival last weekend, which was a real joy. I think our next gig is at the Mushroom Festival that's going to be coming up. It's befitting because we're all psychonauts. and then from that...
Is that the one out in Shelby Forest?
Yeah. Right under the toadstool. Yeah, just look for us with all the fun guys over there. And then
right across the street from my house.
Oh, cool. And then, yeah, we play regularly, and that's and we just released our third all-original album. I've got a few copies of the CD here, which is great. It's getting good reviews. And then with some other combination, people playing in D.C. and then in Costa Rica at the Grateful Hotel. So,
nice.
Yeah. You're all welcome to come there. It's pretty lovely. You got a bunch of howler monkeys screaming behind you while you're playing. It's really a beautiful experience. Big iguanas on the roof, you know.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And you are also willing to autograph any body parts?
Yeah.
So that's an option, too. Yeah. How about you, Tyler? What you got coming up, buddy?
Yeah, so like I said, I'm in two bands here around town. Dream Crusher, Hope Smasher. We're in the midst of getting ready to probably drop a couple new singles. We're on Spotify, Apple Music, and all that jazz. Same with Everdeen's. We're getting ready to record some older stuff, but also start working on a brand new full-length, our first full-length. We've got a show coming up at Lamplighter on the 23rd with Dizzy's going to be playing as well. And then the next day, Dizzy and Everdeens will be playing a little showcase at Voodoo Cafe. And then I'll be heading up to Cincinnati July 7th with Everdeens to play a show, possibly the following weekend as well, but we'll see what happens.
Does anybody else have a question for a particular artist or everybody? Okay, then I'll ask. Every musician I've spoken to, they can't really say one influence that they've had. You know, there's so many, but just from the hip, what would you say is one of your biggest influences? We'll go ahead and start with you and come this way, Tyler.
As a guitar player, I was a really big, once I started learning, John Frusciante of the Chili Peppers was like, you know, someone that I really kind of took a liking to. Growing up, like I said, my dad listened to a lot of Prince, Kiss, a lot of variety of stuff, but as I've gotten older and in recent time, I'd probably say my biggest inspiration has been a band from Canada called Bahamas, lead guitarist, and pretty much the front man of the band is named Afy Jernigan, and his particular style of playing and singing was something that seemed effortlessly close to like what I do, so I've always kind of taken that more presently. But joining Dream Crusher, these guys have been giving me a lot of new music and artists that I've never even heard of. I heard of two artists tonight that I, you know, never really even listened to before, so I'll be, you know, perpetually learning stuff with them too. So the influences of the people that we meet as we go on in this scene is always going to be impactful as well.
That's a great part about music. It's the gift that keeps on giving. It never really gets, some music gets old, but it never gets old that music is around and hearing new talents and what come along. How about you, Michael?
Yeah, I really love so much music, and it goes back, and so, you know, I like a lot of world music and country music from every country. I've got a big collection of 78s from many countries with different types of instrumentation. My favorite songwriter is Hoagy Carmichael, you know, wrote Georgia on My Mind and many other songs like that. You know, favorite singer is probably Elvis.
Also diverse.
Yeah, and yeah. I grew up playing punk and heavy metal and then just kind of started taking a lot of psychedelics. Listening to a lot of different kinds of stuff.
I like
it
everything
opens you
from
up. Yeah, it's a common theme.
I like everything from Merle Haggard to Slayer. So
yeah, I'm with you.
Everything
in
between. It's hard to pinpoint one thing.
Yeah.
How about you?
Well, if I had to say just one, I'd say that anytime I'm sitting down to write a song, I can't escape the echoes of all the John Prine music I've listened to over my whole life. I feel like every time I write a song, I'm like, I hope this doesn't sound too much like a John Prine song, but since moving to Nashville, I've gotten really into Merle Haggard and George Jones and Lefty Frizzell, we were talking about earlier, Hank and Hank Jr. I also been really into Bob Wills recently. That's right. But if I had to just pick one, I'd say John Prine. There's just an unescapable influence from that was like the one artist just growing up that was always playing in the backyard, in the car, you know, everywhere. The list goes on.
Stacy and I got to see one of his last performances in the Dominican Republic for his festival he put on out there.
Yeah.
And we almost didn't go because, you know, it's not, traveling is expensive. And now I can't think of how much I would have kicked myself on the ass had I not made it to that show.
Yeah.
So he's one of my favorite artists as well.
Yeah.
So. All right, unless anybody has any other questions, we're going to let them wrap this night up with one more song each. And then do y'all want to go into a jam session or?
Sure, yeah.
The night is you guys. Thank you for coming out, guys. Appreciate it.
Absolutely.
The stage is yours.
Well, this last one, it doesn't have too crazy of a story to it. It's just it's a song I wrote about trying to find love while couch surfing. It's called If I Can't Have Your Love, I'll Be Sleeping in the Rain. And if you like it, it's one of the few songs I have recorded and up on Spotify. And I recorded it last year, and I'm really proud of how it turned out. So give it a listen when you get a chance. And thanks to Mort for putting this together, and Michael and Tyler here for sharing their songs as well, and for y'all for coming out and listening. You know, if a tree falls in the woods. If I can't have your love, I'll be sleeping in the rain, sleeping in the rain, my head hanging low. If I can't have your love, I'll be sleeping in the rain. Poor heart's got nowhere left to go. I wish that I was driving on the highway, I-95 southern bound, with you sleeping to my right, music playing low, so low, can't hear the thunderclouds. If I can't have your love, I'll be sleeping in the rain, sleeping in the rain. Hanging low. If I can't have your love, I'll be sleeping in the rain. Now poor heart's got nowhere left to go. I was a dollar in your hand. Trade me now for anything you need. Then you spend all waking day doing everything you can to try to go and earn me back again. If I can't have your love, I'll be sleeping in the rain, sleeping in the rain, my head hanging low. Love out, sleeping in the rain. Now my poor heart's got nowhere left to go. Oh, my poor heart's got nowhere left to go.
Thank you.
I want to echo what he said. Thank you so much, Martin, for everything you do for Memphis music. Deeply appreciate it. I wasn't going to do this song. I don't know if I'm going to even remember all the words, but this is one I wrote. It's kind of, I think it's befitting now. And Tyler, my new friend, your friend who committed suicide, what's his name?
Dallas.
Dallas. And Dallas lived with a former bandmate of mine who's moved away. I met him before. And so, in his honor, I'm going to sing this song that I wrote about suicide. And suicide's a very complex thing for me. You know, it's always a riddle. My father committed suicide. And when I was in high school, like many folks, how many of you grew up in Memphis? Raise your hand if you did. Not very many, huh? Mm-hmm. So, anyway, where Channel 3 and Church on the River is, you know, that area over there? So we would always, you know, we would begin the night with a six-pack that we would drink ourselves and a bottle of Robitussin or something and go down there, you know, and just kind of party, try to kiss girls. And that's when the old bridge, I guess, was a little more active. It's now the Big River Crossing. But we would just go down there and hang out. And then we'd get a little buzzed, and then we would go and start climbing on the bridge and, you know, tempting fate. But we got about a third of the way on the bridge one night, and we saw that there was this guy just standing in the middle, almost like this, and he was completely naked, and then he just jumped in the Mississippi, you know, committed suicide. And when you're in 10th grade, that'll stick with you, traumatize you for a little while. And then later, I was at my uncle's funeral. He had also committed suicide, and the preacher said something that resonated with me. He said, you know, even for a nanosecond, that must have seemed like a good idea, you know, to him at that moment. Yeah. So it's all you can hope for. little peace and a little quiet. But this is about the experience. I tried to empathize with that guy who was on the bridge and just try to feel how he felt, you know. Must have been so desperate and so lonely, you know, without hope. Just stripped, dispossessed.
Gonna jump, jump in the river and see what's down below. And I'm not going across, not going across, gonna sink till I die. You can have my bloody clothes and keep these brains, keep all my funny bones, can't stand the pain. You keep all the skin, don't need this wetsuit, can't wear it, heaven Lord, where the smoke to John the Conqueror. Drag the wide net. And I'll be satisfied. How much you wanna bet? You can have my bloody clothes. Keep these brains. Keep all my funny bones, can't stand the pain. You keep all the skin, I won't need a wetsuit. Can't wear it, heaven Lord, where the smoke to John the Conqueror. Gonna jump, jump in that water, see what's down below, sink until I touch bottom, let it happen real slow. Real slow.
Thank you.
Yeah. it's kind of funny that you mentioned that, you know, at your uncle's funeral, you heard something that kind of stuck with you. I was going to preface this next song. Like I said, no stranger to grief and loss. And when I was in the sixth grade, my best friend was unfortunately taken by a drunk driver, and looking back at it, it's kind of crazy that I spoke at his funeral, because I mean, I was in the sixth grade, and this was now, it's now World of Overcomers, but this used to be Central Church, and that place was so packed out that people were standing in the aisles, And I went up and spoke about my last moments with him because we both lived in the same neighborhood and we walked, you know, on the same side of the street until I joined my brother to go back to my side. And then, I mean, maybe 2 minutes later, he's gone from this earth. And, you know, the preacher had a sentiment where he spoke about, and he pointed at the casket, he pointed at my friend Malcolm, and he said, you know, that's the banana peel. And we've all consumed the banana, meaning that, you know, this is just a shell, and the good stuff, the spirit, is something that we all are continuing to take with us. And this particular song, I remember the first time I heard it, I was up at Pickwick with a group of friends in Dallas, brought his guitar, and at the time I was god-awful at playing guitar, but he was like, oh, let me, you know, I'm gonna play this new song. And he's like, you can fuck around on it if you want. And he played this song called Mesmer. And there's some lyrics that are pretty on the nose and some that leave up to open interpretation. But, you know, I think that we all get in our head about what other people might think about us. And they don't know the true story. They don't know who we are. They don't know where we came from, what we've had to deal with. They just kind of are quick to judge us by what they see. And, you know, sometimes people get a little bit over their heads about what they believe about people and, you know, get kind of have their heads in the clouds a little bit. So I'm, you know, it's a beautiful thing to be able to play his music because I kind of feel like in a way I'm spreading a little bit of that banana around these walls right now. I know that's a very weird thing to say, but, you know, there's a group of people in this room, you know, that may have never heard these songs, and I think it's great that, you know, I'm able to take that, and for the, as long as I can, you know, my fingers and my body allows me to pick up a guitar and play in front of people, I will continue to play his songs. so this song is called Mesmer. Deep in the palm of the abyss, when I find myself 2 inches tall and soaked in piss, I've been weeping, scared after death, scared shitless about what people would say if they knew. But I feel as I consciously shift, and now I'm perfectly sound, witness to gifts placed beneath my nose forever. Syntax I miss to you, open my eyes again and simply say, wait till you. Sounds like a 50 Cent album, you know, at the beginning. Lighter flick. Conscious but not comprehensive, I nod. While under the spell of hypnotism,
I'm a dog on a leash, you cry. Despite my sunny disposition, I am not in my state of mind, the spiritual position to follow you on this lonely ride. And simply say, wait till a little more sober. Thank you.
Why not?
I ain't doing no more singing. So whatever y'all want to do, I'm cool. Sure. With yeah.
So I want to thank these guys one last time. Noah G. Fowler, Michael Graber, Tyler Beretta.
Thank you.
Their music is fantastic, but it's useless without your ears. So thank you guys too.
And yeah.
Thanks for the casino sounds, too. That was great. So this is personally my favorite part. As far as I know, have any of you played together before?
No.
So we're going to get what we get, but I've never been disappointed yet. These guys are going to do what musicians do, and they're going to play music and collaborate, and we'll see what happens. Thanks again. I love you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
Pound hammer, a little too heavy for my size, for my size. Roll on, buddy, roll so slow. How can I roll when the wheels won't go? See my baby, ain't coming back, ain't coming back. Roll on, buddy, roll so slow. How can I roll? Roll so slow. And when I die, won't you carve my tombstone? Number 9 cold. Roll on, buddy, don't you kill John Henry. He's gonna kill me. He's gone. Well, buddy, which roast? How can I roll? Well, the wheels won't go. Well, buddy, which roast? How can I roll? Well, the wheels won't go.
Yeah.
So we need to do some more, huh? A real easy one. Okay. All right. This one's just it's in G, but it starts on the four. It's kind of, it's a lot slower. It's okay. A sing along, midnight special. So it's that work for you?
Yeah.
When you wake up in the morning, you hear the ding and the dong and the ring. March you to the table. It's the same old. Over on the table, knife, fork, and a pan. You say anything about it, you in trouble with the man. Let the midnight special shine a light on me. Let the midnight you come to Memphis, and boy, you better walk right, or you better not stagger, and you better not fight. Oh, the sheriff, he'll arrest you. Oh, he'll take you down. The jury finds you guilty. You'll pay. Let the midnight special shine its light on me. Let the midnight special shine its ever-loving light on me. Stand old Rosie, how in the world do I know? I can tell about her apron and her calico. She walked over to the warden, piece of paper in her hand, and it read, I love you for my man.
Lyrics to this one, help me sing it. I kind of slugged that one, but I don't have any anymore.
You did fine, man.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. We should probably do one more.
Yeah.
I'm going to take y'all's lead on this one.
All
right. I feel like something standard. What about if we did an 80s new wave song, old school style? Huh? There's a reason for this. I'm really nervous. I got an anxious disposition, and singing helps me, but... There's a lot of stuff going on, so I don't know if you know this, but we've got warships in China, and we just flew out a bunch of war planes to go dogfight some Russian, and I just, you know, This is a song, it's an anti-war song by a band called New Order, called Love Vigilantes, and it was about this guy that went and fought in the Falkland Islands a while back, and he died and didn't know it.
It's G, C, and A minor. It's really just the whole way through.
Just come from the land of the sun, from a war that must be won in the name of truth. Our country so brave, your soldiers we must save with our rifles and grenades and some help from God. I want to see my family, my wife and child waiting for me. I got to go home, been so long, you see. Oh, you just can't believe the joy I did receive when I finally got my leave. I was going home. I flew through the sky, my conviction would not lie. For my country, I would die, and I would see it soon. I want to see my family, my wife and child waiting for me. I got to go home, been so alone, you see. When I walked through the door, my wife, she lay there on the floor with tears, her eyes were sore, I did not know why. When I looked into her hand, there I saw the telegram saying I was a brave, brave man, but that I was dead. I want to see my family, my wife and child waiting for me. I got to go home, been so alone, you see.
All right, both you guys, take it.
Go, 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 go.
To all you good people out there. Thank you so much.
thanks again for coming out, y'all. That magic that just happened, that was just for you. Nobody else gets to see that. If you don't go out to live shows, you don't get that experience. So you got to see art as it happens. And again, thanks for everybody for being out here. Y'all drive safe.
Yeah, I did it. Let's both do it at the same time. Ready? One, two.